This is RAF Wethersfield, home of 819th Red Horse. There's still a lot of movement around base. As a lot of people are now moving out, and about half of the base has moved out. This is the placard telling us what Red Horse is about. Just a little of the history. Here the bank, the dollar rate is 1.86 to the pound. Not so good for the Americans, but good for the English. Just behind the bank is the library. Just here is the library, which was very nice. It supplied records, CDs, tapes, and all the latest books. And beyond that is the auto hobby shop. There you can repair your cars, etc. And also was the ceramic shop and the wood hobby shop. And behind that is the club. Consolidated open mess, but actually this is the rear of it, and we'll be seeing the entrance in a moment. That is the entrance to the club, which is very small, but it's large inside and apparently has the largest dance floor in England. Nice discos are held here every weekend. Usually once a month they have an all-nighter disco. This is where the troops get drunk and hang out here. We're now inside the club. This is the bar part of the club. This is where most of the money is spent. Behind me are the one-armed bandits. A lot of money is spent in there, and occasionally a lot of money is won back.
This year, even though his season average is low for him,
they're usually at their busiest when the troops are paid. Hey. Every 2 weeks. This is the entrance to the club. This is where the local hop is, and this Saturday is going to be the last disco here, which will be an all-nighter. Generally there's a cover charge of about £2 to get in for the English.
Rooftops.
Who are taking pictures of?
Oh, just the base, everything in general, really. I think I'll just go for a walk.
Is this for you or for what?
Yeah, it is really.
Thank you.
6 squadron, of which I belong to. And behind there is the fire department. We're now coming up to the Red Horse warehouse, and beyond that is the carpenter shop. Just before me is the parachute hangar where they used to dry out the parachutes, and to the right of that is the vehicle maintenance shop, of which the forecourt is around it, and that used to be filled up with vehicles ready to be repaired. Just a few of the vehicles left of the base. They will soon be gone as well. And sport fitness. This is the Nautilus room, and as you can see, it's full of equipment which is used for different areas of the body. If used efficiently, they're very good. Just opposite Jersey's house is the American Independence School, and the grades run from first grade up to, I believe, 12th grade. We're now on family housing. There's about 150 houses. Of 2, 3, and 4 bedrooms. This is Scott Avenue where Jessie lives. Jessie lives the second one in from the left. This is looking up the road. This is the command section of the 819th Red Horse, and the commander is Colonel High, who we shall be seeing in one moment. This is building 66. Good afternoon, Colonel High. This is Colonel High, the base commander of the 819th Red Horse. How has your stay been here, Colonel High?
Well, it's been just great. The only problem is, it's been too short. We got here in July, the middle of July last year, and now we're leaving on the 1st of August, and I feel like we were cheated out of 2 years of stay in England. But the year we were here was just super.
That's very nice. We shall all miss you too. You've been a very good commander. And we hope to see you back here again sometime, visiting around this area.
Well, we probably will come back and visit.
That's nice.
What's made this place so special and so good was all the people who were here. They were all each wonderful people to work with and work for, and it made our stay here very pleasant and enjoyable and something to remember. So anything I have done, it's only because we had good folks here really doing all the work while I could watch.
That's right. I understand a lot of the men are very sad to be moving out too. They've enjoyed their stay here.
Yeah, I think so. Fortunately, most people are going to a job, into a location they think is exciting, and they are exciting, and so they'll get on with their life and get involved in a new job, in a new base, and I hope they'll have fond memories of Wethersfield and the Red Horse.
Well, that's Colonel High. Thank you, Colonel High.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Hope to see you back here soon.
Okay. Come
Thank
see
you.
Us in South Carolina.
Right. Shop of 819th Red Horse. This is where Jesse works. These trucks are ready to be repaired or have been repaired. Now we shall go inside and see what happens.
vehicle in there at 7.7.
Right.
This is Sergeant Maury. Fire department. Coming up is the control tower.
The 19th Air Base flight will now be inactivated by Major DeBerry. Major DeBerry and Sergeant Kelly will inactivate their unit by passing the guide on to Colonel Hoff. Attention to orders. Special order GB32. The 719.
Chapter in the history of the 819th and of RAF Wethersfield. It has been a solemn, emotional ceremony, as it should be, because none of us enjoys seeing a unit inactivated, its colors cased, and a base closed. But there is a positive side that we should not ignore. The fact that these actions are taking place is a clear, visible measure of our success. Success of the NATO alliance in reducing the threat of conflict in Europe.
They got over the big tent.
Huh?
Yeah. Over the big tent, they got about twice as much food.
Well, I kind of figured it. Did they have any puncher?
Yeah, I think they did. Yeah.
I want to go that way.
I seen a guy carrying some. So.
Oh. There we go.
Oh, yeah.
Now, this is going to be an action photo.
Uh-oh. Oh, my goodness. An action photo.
No.
This is Sergeant Jesse Oldham's house. And I think we can find him sitting down in the chair as usual. I was asleep. Okay.
Hello. Welcome to Jesse's house, Carol's nightmare.
On Scott Avenue.
Uh-huh.
We're just waiting for Jo and Gary and her family to come to dinner for farewell dinner. If I can just get past here. Oh. This is the outside. Sun's shining.
Go on out in the backyard and take a picture out by the back fence towards the house. Shut it off now.
Zooming in up on Jesse. We're going to walk into the back entrance of the house.
Still trying to film up my shorts, huh?
This is the patio.
That's a tree. Just that.
There's Charlie the plant.
Want to see George the tree?
That's upstairs, but I won't take the camera up there, I don't think. Bit of a mess. There's the kitchen and the shepherd's pie cooking at the moment. Don't think you can smell it on the camera. The house looks out onto the school opposite. The elementary school from first grade up to ninth grade. Oh, Jesse, we're filming. Propaganda film.
Yeah, I was literally on my hands and knees around here tending to all these beautiful flowers. They're all dying now because I've been moved out for a while. I've not been able to take care of them.
Oh my God.
But I just sweated over these things. It's spent so many hours in labor trying to get them to grow, and they come up beautiful. They wouldn't have done it had not been working so hard on them. That's my house. This is the back door. Somebody left the door open, so I have to go close it.
Hello. This is Colonel High's house, the present commander of 819th Red Horse. As you can see, it's a bungalow. Just in front are the rest of the family quarters, mainly officers' quarters. Poor Jesse getting into his van again. There he goes. This is outside barrack 1029, and inside is Ronnie, who's the linen exchange manager. We're now inside the barrack. This is Ronnie sitting at her desk in the linen exchange. She's the manager of all the things that get done around here. She's in charge of the dorms as well, and she keeps an eye on the troops. Ronnie is trying to start up a business too. She's into selling china. I'm not sure what the make is. What is it, Ronnie?
Marquise.
Marquise?
Yeah.
And is it made in England?
Yeah, Stoke-on-Trent. Family painting.
Yeah. It's all hand-paid,
yeah.
Hand-painted, isn't it?
Yeah. So,
very you have, pretty.
So, I have to sing, Who Buy My Lovely China?
Not my violets. Oh, that is bone china, all right.
That's right. £12.50 a plate. Make me an offer. Blue. This is called Princess Royal. Okay. And we can have tea for Carolyn. An English cup of tea.
Oh, thank you. That looks good. And rubber china too.
That's right. Right, I've got the blue and the yellow. Then we have the bowls to match. Honestly. Can you hear that ring in your camera?
Oh, yes.
That comes in various patterns. This is Evesham. And those sell at £45 each.
How much is a cup and saucer?
These?
Yes.
These, to you, madam, £10. Cup and saucer.
The new sports car.
There you go. I will take this one back.
You're taking it back, Karen?
Huh?
Taking it back?
Yes. Or shipping one over like it. Something to that effect.
That's a little better.
This is Joe and Gary's house. She's fixing dinner at the moment. That's the back of Joe and Gary's house.
Hey, hi, Carol.
Hello, Carol.
This is Jesse's last supper at Joe and Gary's.
Yeah, this is the last supper.
This is the last supper, yeah.
How you doing?
And her cookbook.
It's that pan.
How you doing over there?
Okay, how are you, Aaron? Looking forward going to the States?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to go to Germany now. Get you a little behind down, please.
Very nice.
Yeah, Carol.
Cut the table.
Carol.
And I said, we really need to honor.
Yeah.
Hi, Jesse. Have a good time. Not too good a time, though.
I had a real good time.
No.
In a couple of years.
There goes Jetty off on his vacation.
We're not going home though, right?
There's everybody else waiting to leave Wethersfield. The last day here. Gary saw Jesse off.
That's my car.
This is inside one of the TLF rooms, which Red Horse did themselves. TLF stands for Temporary Living Quarters.
Temporary Family Living. TLF.
This is the lounge, dining room, kitchen. The bathroom. This is the bedroom. There's Bunny. 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 Give us a smile. Bunny. Bunny. There we have the base theatre, where all the feature films are played at. It's the Bay's Chapel. At the moment, it's Chuck and Perry who features there. The chapel. Where most of the services are held throughout Sundays. The Base Theatre, where many good films were held, all the latest films too. Where I work at the moment, they're putting the fence up. Above that is the microwave tower, which is pointing in the direction of Malkenberry. I There's Fiona. She's the supervisor of the switchboard.
Did you not get through?
The kitchen where we make our cups of coffee and tea and...
Good, operator 4.
This is inside the switchboard. Anne and Jill and Fiona is working at the moment.
Yes, sir.
2204.
Still like to hold?
It's ringing for you.
1:17, 10:17.
Wethersfield, operator 4.
This is Wednesday afternoon, and generally we do our stateside calls.
Sorry, there's no reply.
We're not very busy this afternoon.
Sorry to keep you waiting, the number's still busy.
This is the frame room behind the switchboard where it all happens. All the telephone numbers that are dialed throughout the base come through this network and then into the switchboard. All this these days is replaced by just a small box. These are the 5 meters that I read every day. The units are clocked up on these. The unit at the moment is worth about sixpence including VAT. Usually get about 2 units to a call. This is the upper end of the frame room. It makes a noise once everything is going. The food to all of the troops. Going inside the base theatre. That's the ticket office to the right. And now inside the base theatre. At the moment there's just a TV film on. The screen's not in use. This is the chow hall again.
been done already.
This is inside the kitchen. Chow hall, as it's known.
Baker's food.
What is it, sea chicken?
Cornish hen, mashed potatoes, and gravy.
Oh, very nice. That's the sort of meals they normally serve up. Got it on? Yes, he has.
Oh, yes, he has.
Now you gotta say who you're filming.
I'm filming. That's all that matters.
We'll take one of another shot.
Okay. Wide angle.
No, not too fast now.
Are you happy? I do this for you, Carol.
Not too fast.
Ooh. There he is.
Here we are. This is Dee. Dee and Sergeant Hewden's going away party.
I'll clean it up.
Where are you going?
All right. If it's going to be our going away party, get it right, sweetheart. I'm Chief Hewden.
What did I say? What's the
everything that
Sergeant,
you
said,
what you've always said.
What?
And I'm Sergeant Hewden.
Oh no, I slipped up. It's the booze.
Redundant, huh?
Yeah.
So about February, you got to go to work.
Before that. I am sitting around 6 months, yeah.
But you have to go to work by February.
You relieved of cross line.
Well.
When were you relieved of duties officially?
Tomorrow morning at 5:30.
Oh, we still are. Oh, let's put our cups of tea away.
This is our chief. I said it again.
Chief Master Sergeant. Yeah.
9:09, please.
You'll get it right someday.
How's your stay been here, Chief?
I've loved it.
In England?
I love England.
Oh, good. Sorry to go then.
Yes.
Oh, you'll be back again, won't you? For leave?
Probably.
On leave, maybe? Well, we'll probably see you next time then.
Okay.
All the best.
Bye-bye.
In here is the Autobahn room.
You're taking it.